Morning, Mrs. Lambert.
Did Mr. Lavery come by here today?
Duke? Well, not since I've been up, but I've only been here for about 15 minutes.
Oh, who did you take over from?
A new man. I'll get his name for you if you like.
Yeah, if you don't mind.
Sure.
Thank you. Alain! You rang? Oh, yeah, what's the matter?
It's been mishmash around here today.
Did you call at all?
No one called since I talked to you.
I see.
I have to explain a few things. Like, you know, in happenings.
What kind of happenings?
Oh, man, bizarre.
Like what?
Well, I was out front talking to the man when the wind blew the front door shut, locked out. And wouldn't you know it, just at that moment, the phone rang. Oh, man, it was like being in a bathtub or a shower, if you know what I mean.
I think so.
So I ran full steam around the back door, but too late. When I got to the phone, no one was there.
It doesn't matter, you'll be on the machine.
I don't think you'll find anyone there.
Why not?
Well, I turned the machine off.
Why?
Because I thought I was here.
Ah. Anything else?
Only that. When I was down in the cellar with the laundry, some man tried to pass the guy in the front. I came up to the kitchen, dropped the basket, clothes all over the floor. I could sort of hear them arguing out there, but by the time I picked everything up, whoever it was no longer there.
That could have been Duke.
No, he was at the club with you.
Not exactly. Things have been pretty bizarre for me, too.
What's with you?
Well, I got stood up. Twice.
How's that?
Van Woods didn't keep her appointment. Then Duke didn't show up either. Or somehow I missed him.
Oh, chum. How about I make you a cup of tea?
Yeah, a large one.
Oh, I slipped up again.
What else?
Just before you called on the telephone, Commissioner Scorpio phoned. He's due to arrive any time now.
It was certainly a plainclothes cop.
Did he see anything?
There was nothing to see. The office was good as new.
Duke Lavery's.
Is Duke there, please?
May I see who's calling?
Anna Devane.
Oh, I thought I recognized your voice, Anna.
Is that Miss St. John? I didn't recognize you.
How may I help you?
Well, is Duke there by any chance?
Well, no. I thought he was with you and poor Charles.
No. If you see him, would you ask him to call his wife? I'm at home. Thank you.
A dangerous game, daughter.
Challenging.
If you should see Duke, tell him I want to see him tomorrow.
If I should see Duke, I will.
Oh, you'll see him. Be careful, Olivia.
I will. Very careful, Father. Very careful. There was a message I was supposed to give to Duke. Oh, let's see. I think I'll forget about it now and think of it tomorrow. It's a good idea. Hello. Oh.
What do we celebrate?
I don't know. I'll think of something.
You're expecting something?
Not really. Why?
Champagne? Unless you got a drink on your own.
I do like to have a glass of champagne once in a while, but I'm glad you're here.
It's the first time I've had that all day.
Oh, really? Bad times in Port Charles.
Yep, you could say that.
I'm sorry.
It's not for you to worry about. Would you like me to open this?
Well, sure. Why not?
Excellent choice.
Thank you.
So, what are we going to drink to?
Happier moments for you in Port Charles. How's that?
Yeah. Happier moments.
For all of us. My father stopped by today.
Oh, really? What did he want?
He wanted to make sure he could meet with you tomorrow, if you're staying.
Yeah, I'll be here.
Well, then, why don't you take off your jacket and loosen your tie a little bit and, you know, relax. It's only me.
Yeah, that's right. Why should I at least get comfortable?
No reason I can think of.
Nope. I have nowhere else to go.
Evening, Commissioner.
What are you doing here?
I was assigned, sir.
By whom?
Chief Lewis.
Why would he do that without telling me?
Because I told him to.
I'm going to have Lewis's head for this.
We'll do no such thing. This men were posted there for the well-being of your daughter.
I don't mean because he did it. Because he did it without telling me.
I'd have done the same thing if I'd been chief.
Then I'd have fired you.
You think you are the only one capable of making decisions in that department?
Yes. Incidentally, why did you feel the necessity for added protection?
Well, there's been some strange characters hanging around here lately.
Well, why not tell me?
You were so busy, I didn't want to.
We're talking about my daughter, Anna. I should always be informed.
Why are we discussing this? Robin's gone off to camp today, and the men are going to be removed.
She's gone to camp already? Look, what am I, some sort of a mushroom around here? Didn't it occur to you that I might want to say goodbye to her?
Robert, do you just come over here to harass me?
No. I kind of feel you're hiding something.
You know where the door is. Goodbye.
I'll find out, Anna.
Goodbye, Robert.
It's to do with that grease-bucket husband of yours,
goodbye.
Isn't it?
Goodbye!
Lavery, what are you up to now?
Rodolfo, Santa. Isn't he thoughtful?
Yeah. Certainly is the best.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Try one. Well, what do you think?
It reminds me of home.
Port Charles?
Home. Home. Scotland.
Really? That's funny.
What's so funny?
You've just eaten anguilla... anguilla marinata.
I'm using that?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What is it?
It's pure Italian. It's marinated eel.
We have eels in Scotland.
You do?
No. Except, you know, they have slimier eels in Australia.
Oh.
Do another glass of champagne?
Yes. Yes, please.
Yeah.
think that it's pretty funny that a Scottish person is eating all this Italian food. See, that's... Well, I don't know what you all eat. What do you eat? Here.
What is this?
This is shrimp with little pieces of lettuce.
We don't eat this.
You don't.
No.
Do you like it, though?
Is there anything else?
Well, no, there isn't. There isn't anything left. Rodolfo! You think he's still down there? He's down. I'm sorry. I couldn't help.
There's more champagne?
Yes, I do. We haven't finished that yet?
No. One for you. One for me?
Mm-hmm.
Music stopped.
Oh, well, can't do anything about music, so you pour and I'll get the music.
Okay.
Oh. Fill that up.
Everyone dances.
No, everyone doesn't dance. Everyone does not dance in my family.
Everyone in my family dances.
Oh, really? This I have to see. Other than the Highland Fling, other than the...
The Highland Fling is for tourists.
Oh.
I can dance.
Really?
Last time.
Okay. What?
Call this the Highland Fling?
No, not at all. You can dance.
You can dance too. Got myself in trouble this time, didn't I? Thank you.
Well, Mr. Lavery, you're a wonderful lover.
Dear love, I miss you so much. Lynn just mopes around the house and asks, how's my little Robin doing? I'll be up for a visit pretty soon. The thing that makes me happy is knowing that you're having a good time. Daddy misses you. And so does Uncle. You never called me back. Bet you shouldn't give him my message.
I trust you slept well.
Very well, thank you.
Champagne is known to have that effect.
Please don't mention that word.
I know what you mean.
You too.
I have a little pain behind my right eye.
In that case, you're lucky.
I know.
Did I hear the phone ring a couple of minutes ago?
Yes. It was the wrong number.
What time is it?
9:15.
Still early, huh?
Mm-hmm. You're wonderful.
So are you.
Am I?
Yeah. So, what's on the agenda for this morning?
We have a meeting at 10:30 and a very busy afternoon. We have some time now. Do you want to use it?
You know, my head feels like it's about to fall off my shoulders. I don't get something to eat soon. I'm probably going to die. Would you like something?
Orange juice for starters. The rest is up to you.
Get dressed. I'll be right back.
No goodbye kiss.
I haven't brushed my teeth yet. I'm going to pick up some toothpaste, toothbrush, whatever. I'll be back.
Feeling a little guilty this morning, hmm? That's okay. Let's take this step by step. You love me, Duke. I'll make you love me.
Better.
Yeah. I didn't think I was going to be able to eat breakfast when I woke up this morning, but a nice shower makes me feel better. How was yours?
How was my what?
Your shower.
It was fine, thank you very much.
These are good, aren't they?
Yeah. What time is our first meeting?
10:30.
Good. Guess somebody got here a little earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Morning, boss. Thought you might like a little breakfast. Our kitchen isn't open, so I went across the street and got you an egg and muffin and some coffee.
Oh, that's very kind of you, Rodolfo. Actually, I've already had breakfast. Miss St. John came over early and she brought me some today.
Yeah, I see what you mean. Good morning, Miss St. John.
Good morning, Rodolfo. I'm glad to see you're so concerned with Mr. Lavery's well-being.
Part of my job. I better get this out of here.
Yeah, leave the coffee, would you? I think I might need that.
Right. See y'all later.
Okay.
Thank you. None of this is a laughing matter. Something happened last night, and I appreciate if it was left just like that.
What do you mean?
What happened was between us. It's nobody else's business.
Do you think I'd want it any other way?
Okay, I was
going to
go out
for some
fresh air.
I could do that for you.
Oh, I need to get out of the office.
Okay.
All right, see you later.
Okay,
bye.
At 10:30, we meet with the protection department. At 1 o'clock with prostitution. We have a break from 4:30 to 5, and drugs is after that.
Any feedback on the attitudes concerning the proposed changes?
It's hard to read those people, except for drugs.
Meaning?
Meaning that drugs is against any change whatsoever.
We'll see about that.
I'm sure you will.
Olivia,
what are you doing here, Olivia?
I asked her to come up here.
Stay out of this. I'm speaking to my daughter.
Father, please. I was merely briefing Duke on the meetings we have today.
I want you out of here.
Take it easy, Victor. She'll be gone by the time the meeting starts.
It's close enough. Olivia, out. Where are your shoes? I never want to see you up here again. Never.
Why not?
Because we conduct business in the office downstairs. This apartment is for Duke's use when he's in town, and Duke alone.
You are so adorable when you're angry, Daddy. Good luck with your meetings today.
Thank you for your help.
You're welcome. Thank you.
By the way, Duke, did you get a message your wife called for you last night?
I called here last night.
That's right.
Are you sure?
I was here at the time.
Who took the,
Olivia took the message.
I suppose she just forgot to tell me then, yeah.
Well, that's a woman for you.
Yeah.
If you haven't spoken with your wife today, perhaps you'd like to call her before the meeting begins.
It's a very good idea, thank you.
We'll give you some privacy. Phil?
Lane Donnelly Investigations.
Alicia, Duke is out of that place.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. She just stepped out.
But she's coming right back. Do you want me to take a message?
Yeah, tell her I called and tell her also that... Tell her I'm in the club apartment in New York. She knows the number.
Okay, I will. Anything else?
No. That's all, thank you. I thought Olivia did this. I'm gonna find out.
Excuse me, boss. The first group's already downstairs.
Send them up in 10 minutes.
Why not downstairs?
Because I want the meeting to be up here.
All right, Rodolfo. Send them up here.
You better bring up some beer and some wine, and you better bring them something to eat. I'm sure these guys want to eat.
Right away.
We'll play it your way, Duke. For now.
Office.
No, actually, you're in the right office and we're in the wrong office.
Yeah. We'll go over to mine.
Oh, no, don't go. It's nice to see your face, stranger.
Oh, it's good to see yours, too. And just as pretty as ever.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, Anna, before I forget, Duke called.
Oh, he did?
He said you could reach him at the club apartment in New York and that you have the number.
I do.
Okay, thanks.
Shall we?
Yeah.
Yeah. See you later.
Mrs. Lavery.
Commissioner.
I hope our mood has improved a tad since last night.
I was in a fine mood last night until you came in.
Oh. Well, I'm back again.
So I see.
Why don't we start off all over?
Love to.
Good. I'd like to ask you a civil question, if I may.
Can you?
I think so. I've been giving this some thought, and I'd like to know what you've really done with my daughter.
What do you mean, what have I really done with your daughter?
It was a simple question.
I told you last night she's gone to camp.
You did?
Yes.
Must have slipped my mind.
You don't have a mind.
Oh, now that was uncalled for.
Well, what do you really want?
Which camp?
I'll write your dress down for you.
Appreciate that. So, it's, back to camp, huh?
Yes, she goes every year.
Mm-hmm. Bit early.
So?
Well, it's just an observation. Like I've observed the extra security you had Lewis place around the house.
I told you why I did that.
Oh, yeah. Funny faces in the neighborhood. Do you remember a Detective Crane?
Mm-hmm.
He dropped into town the other day. Pick up an extradition case.
I hope he's well.
Said he'd observed Victor Jerome and some of his scuzzy friends going into Club Duke during the day.
It's a free country. They were probably having lunch.
Yeah, I thought of that. Then I remembered that the club isn't open during the day.
You would remember that.
Yeah. He also remembers seeing a maitre d' in there, former lieutenant of Jerome's. At least that's what Crane said.
Is your daughter's address? Is there anything else?
Come on. Mr. Lavery's back in the rackets and you know it.
Goodbye, Robert.
I'll say this. You can turn a blind eye to all this if you like. But if it means that my daughter's going to be placed in some trouble, then everyone's got a problem. And I don't care whether you're her mother or not. Because you'll all deal with me. One way or another.
So instead of offering out-and-out protection, we'll be selling legitimate insurance policies.
No. Come on, do it.
That's right, everything will be strictly on the up and up. Simmer down, gentlemen, please. No. We'll be selling these policies at reduced rates, not a shakedown price.
Oh, hey, man, what the hell's wrong with
you?
Hold
it, hey, shut up, where we go, all of you. Now you listen to Duke.
Thank you. The profit will come in because the Jerome Foundation will hire a staff to sell these policies. Until we start to turn a profit, and I'm talking about legitimate profit, the Foundation will absorb any loss that is suffered by you. We will continue to offer protection on the streets. against petty thugs, etc., but in the form of security guards. Let me outline the program for all of you, please. Excuse me. Rodolfo, I told you to hold all calls.
This isn't Rodolfo.
Anna, you using the private line?
Yes, the same one I used last night.
I didn't get any message from you.
I gathered that. I'd like to believe it. Can we talk now? Are you alone?
Not exactly. Are you?
Yes.
Anna, listen, I'm sorry, but your handwriting is atrocious.
I was.
All right. I heard Robert's voice. I know he's there.
Yes.
Is this supposed to be a seven here?
Robert, please, I'm on the phone.
I can't talk right now. I can talk later.
Gina, I want to talk.
Accident.
You are so rude.
Look, I'm sorry. You're not... Oh. Well, it looked like an F. I'm sorry. I apologize.
Everything you said did make sense, too. We have to think about it, talk about it, then you will hear from us. Ciao, ci vediamo. Stata buona.
Grazie.
Idus, andiamo. Imagine.
Duke, I don't know how you've done it. I didn't think anybody could get those guys' attention.
Seems to make sense to them, doesn't it?
Did to me.
Is Olivia downstairs?
She's having dinner, I believe.
Would you ask her to come up here?
Right away.
Tell her I want to see her right away.
All right.
Don't wait for the tone. A real live human being is answering your call.
Hi, Olin. Oh, it's you. Is Anna there?
Nobody's around here, Bud, but me.
You expect her, sir?
Late for supper already. You want her to call you back?
You know I do.
Got your best. You at the club in New York?
Yes, I'm upstairs in the apartment.
Okay, Bud. I'll tell her.
Thank you, Olin.
Bye.
Yes.
You wanted to see me?
You could say that, yes.
Oh, who do they think they are? Robert's driving me crazy. Can't even speak to my husband.
You can turn a blind eye to all this if you like. But if it means that my daughter's going to be placed in some trouble, then everyone's got a problem. And I don't care whether you're her mother or not. Because you'll all deal with me, one way or another.
Who does he think he is? She's my child, and I can take care of her. Hey, Chum,
I don't mean to interrupt your conversation. Duke called. Wants you to get back to him ASAP.
Yeah.
On second thought, Chum, forget the ASAP. Maybe you should take a couple of deep breaths first, huh? Good for your voice.
Yes.
Much better. Say goodbye, Olin.
Why should I call him? Every time I call him, he doesn't speak to me.
Deep breaths.
What is this happening to us? Here you go. Or have another one.
Shoot them.
Thank you.
No, good.
Delicious.
Just like you. Trust me, Anna.
I do trust you.
Line's still busy. Olin must be gossiping with her friends.
So how did the meeting go?
Same old story. As with the other groups, they responded fairly well for the most part. I think they understand the advantages, but they just need some time to talk about it.
Well, the others came around sooner or later.
Yes, remember we started out with the easier ones, though.
Well, how does my father view the situation?
He seemed very pleased. You didn't see him when he left downstairs.
No. I was having dinner over in the corner, and he didn't see me. And I wasn't too thrilled with the prospect of getting yelled at for being here anyway.
Now you come to mention it about you being here. You and I together last night. Did Anna call and ask for me to call her?
Of course.
She did. And you didn't tell me.
Of course, and I did tell you.
You did?
Naturally, I told you it was a message for you. You must remember. Even though
what?
You did have a lot of champagne to drink.
I've had a lot to drink before, and I haven't forgotten to call my wife.
Are you suggesting I'm lying?
I'm not suggesting anything. I just cannot imagine.
Because if you are, I can just get out of here
no,
right now.
I didn't mean it like that.
Well, I should hope not. And while you're standing there thinking so hard, why don't you give some quick attention to how you can apologize to me?
Please come into the other room. Take a seat. Hi. Something I want to say, I want you to listen to me.
I'm listening.
I was pretty far gone last night. I'm not using this as an excuse. It was a reason. I shouldn't drink champagne. It doesn't exactly agree with me. I've no reason to doubt what you said about my forgetting to call Anna. I must accept that the way you said it was, that's how it happened.
Is that an apology?
Yes. And it's not the only thing I'm sorry about. If I hadn't been so drunk last night, I wouldn't have taken advantage of you. I'm sorry I did.
Well, there were two participants, as I recall, and you are a very attractive man.
Yes, but you see, I had no right to participate. I love my wife. I love her very much, and you are a lovely and brilliant woman, and you deserve to be treated much better.
Oh, Duke, I admire you much too much for you to ever feel you've taken advantage of me, ever. Really.
Well, you can rest assured that it won't happen again, and I do apologize for it.
Apology accepted. And it was very sweet of you to say it.
Nothing sweet about it. I mean, the way I behaved was very, very bad. It was inexcusable.
Well, it wasn't without its enjoyable moment.
You?
Olin said you wanted me to call.
Yeah, Anna, I'm sorry we've had so much trouble reaching each other. I've been involved in some meetings, some very tense ones.
I can imagine.
I'll try to reach you every spare minute. I either get the busy signal or else I've just missed you.
I guess we're both sorry then. I couldn't talk to you the last time because Robert was hanging around.
Yeah, I thought there was some kind of problem there. I was in the middle of a pretty large meeting myself.
I would like to see you there.
Me too. Whenever you say.
I have to go visit Robin tomorrow at a camp. That's Central State. I could come to the city afterwards.
Well, that's great. Why don't you call me when you leave in the camp?
Okay, I will.
Tomorrow then.
Bye.
I need a love that grows. I don't want it unless I know. Baby, take me out. One somehow will be there, ready to share. I need a love that's strong. I'm so tired of being.
Morning, Charm.
Hi.
Here's your breakfast.
Oh, look at that. Thank you.
I knew you wouldn't have time to chow down like a human being.
No, there's only one fight that'll get me to Robin's camp on time, and if I miss that, that's it.
Oh, man, I sure miss that kid.
Oh, so do I.
You know, ever since she's been away at camp, it's been so quiet around here, I could take naps standing up.
I'd like to see that.
How long will you be gone?
All day.
All day? How come?
I'm going to go and see Duke afterwards.
I sure miss him.
Yeah, me too. Even though we've been having some problems.
You know what Confucius said about marriage?
What did he say?
Hang in there, kid. It ain't all sunshine and soap bubbles.
He said that?
Oh. That's right.
Yeah. I'm not sure. I better go.
Well, you have a good time and give Robin a big kiss for me, all right?
I will.
Oh, I love you. See you later.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Are you sure you maybe haven't got some sub gum chow mein hidden away in the menu there?
What is with you and Chinese food?
I thought I'd ask.
Why aren't you at work?
I'm on my way to camp to visit Robin.
Uh-huh. Flying?
Driving.
What's she doing at camp this early?
Ask her mother.
Okay.
Good morning, Lizzie. Hi, Robert.
Hi,
my darling. Are you going to stay and have breakfast with
no,
us?
No, I don't have time. I'm running late.
Well, make sure you get breakfast at the cafeteria. You hear me?
I will. Bye.
Bye, darling. I don't know what I'm going to do with that girl.
Must have overslept.
Oh, I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to go refill some coffee cups.
I'll be back in a moment, darling.
Take your time. Guy always praises my appetite.
Leaving already?
Yeah, Ruth.
Well, you haven't eaten your donut or finished your coffee.
Air's getting bad around here, Rupert.
The air? Oh, I see what you mean.
Somebody ought to report this guy to the EPA for polluting the planet, didn't
they? Yeah. I wonder why it is other people don't see it.
Beats me.
You drive safely.
I shall.
And give Robin a big hug and a kiss.
You got it. Talk to you soon.
Okay, and I mean that. Drive carefully.
It's a deal.
Okay, now we're going to make sure that we have everything we need for our hike. So let's go down our checklist. Mess kit.
Yeah.
Canteen.
Yeah.
First aid kit.
Yeah.
I forgot mine.
Please go get it, Cynthia.
Yes, Mr.
All right. Are your shoes comfortable?
Yeah.
Good. Because we're going to be on our hike until after lunch.
Oh.
No, come on. Let's not have any of that. Are we all here? Yeah, fine. We're all here. All right. Line up in straight rows of twos. Right here. Okay? About face. March. Excuse me, Mrs.
Yes. How may I help you?
I'm Anna Lavery, and I'm here for Robin.
Oh, yes. We've been expecting you. Robin's over there behind that tent. She's there with her friend.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi.
Oh, Mommy! Hi.
Hi.
This is my best friend, honey.
Hi.
We got poison ivy together.
Oh. Honey, how do you? Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Miss
Lavery. Yeah, look at you two. My goodness, come here.
I'm so glad you're here.
Oh, look, poison ivy's contagious.
Does that mean I don't get any more hugs?
Well, I'll risk it, I guess. So how did you get it?
Well, we were on a nature hike and we were looking for flowers. We found some pretty ones.
Yeah?
Poison ivy, too.
How do you feel?
Okay, except for the itching.
I know, it drives you crazy.
Well, don't scratch too much.
Oh, I just remembered. I've got to make my bunk before Miss Bixby gets back.
All right, okay. See you later.
Bye.
Bye-bye. She's a nice girl.
My best friend.
Oh, good. Sit down. So apart from the poisoned ivy and everything, are you enjoying yourself?
Uh-huh. All the girls are pretty nice, and Miss Bixby's okay.
She's just okay, huh?
You know what I mean.
And the other counselors?
Okay.
Okay. Well, I'm glad you're having a good time anyway.
Yeah, but I wish I could go swimming in the lake.
No, you can't. Not with poison ivy.
I know, darn it. Mommy?
Yes, darling?
How come all the letters I've gotten are just from you?
Well, I gave your daddy the address, too.
I know, but what about Uncle Duke? He's home with you, isn't he?
Actually, he's been in New York probably all the time since you've been here.
Well, that's what why hired Rudolph or whatever his name
Rudolph,
is.
Rudolph.
Rudolph, what? Rudolph, whatever. But that's why you hired him, isn't it?
Yes, I know. Well, he'll be home soon, and I'm sure when he is, he'll write you a letter. So what else have you been doing?
Oh, I've got to show you.
Yes.
I made you a bookmark because you love to read.
Oh, look at that. You made that? Wow, that's great. Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm making one for Daddy and Uncle Duke, too.
Oh, well, if it's half as good as this, I'm sure they're going to love it.
When will they be here to come and see me so I can give them their presents?
Soon, I should think so. Soon.
That's
good. So, listen, when's lunch? I heard Mrs. Bixby say she wasn't coming back till afterwards.
Oh, you should stay. The food is so good.
It is, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Guess what we're having?
Egg salad sandwiches, I don't know.
Chip beef on toast.
Oh, lovely.
Is that all the stuff?
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure.
I better go now.
Okay.
Well, I'll see you in the dining room, okay?
Okay.
Oh. Okay.
Hey!
Oh,
look at this. That's my girl.
Great. I got a present for you.
You have? Well, let's have a look at it.
Yeah. Well, I'm not exactly finished with it.
What's all this stuff all over you?
I got poison ivy.
Is it bad?
Oh, yeah, it itches a lot. And you're gonna get it.
Oh, lucky me.
Well, at least if I catch poison ivy, I'll know what to do.
What?
Well, I'll scratch your back, and you can scratch mine.
What about our arms, legs, and stomach?
Again, I'll scratch yours, and you can scratch mine.
Oh, we're not supposed to scratch.
So we'll cheat. You been having a good time here?
Yeah, great.
Good.
That's what Mommy asked me.
She been here to see you?
Yeah, she's here right now.
She is? Where?
She's in the dining hall waiting for me. Come on, let's go.
Wait, I'm not hungry. I ate on the way up here.
When'd she get here?
About an hour ago.
Daddy?
Hmm?
Will you put some calamine lotion on me, please?
Sure. Okay.
Here's the lotion.
Okay, why don't we, do the arms and the legs first.
All right.
Hold your arms here.
Good. I wish it would go away so I could swim in the lake.
Isn't it a little cold?
No, not unless you get used to it.
Mm-hmm. You fish?
I don't know. I'm so glad you're here. And if Uncle Duke would come in, it'd be just perfect.
Duke, now you're here?
Yeah, why wouldn't he?
Well, he's spending quite a bit of time in New York these days.
Yeah, too much.
Well, I think we're all done.
Yeah. Okay. I'll put this back. Do you want to see your present, even though it's not finished?
I'd love to see it. Hey, this is great. Is it my size?
Yep, I asked Mommy.
Can't wait to wear it.
Great. You like it?
Mmm.
I made one just like, for Uncle Duke, but it's kind of different.
Sure.
What are you doing here?
Visiting Robin.
But it's different.
This is really great. No more suspenders from now on.
Yeah.
Will you guys wait for me? I have to go check about my poison ivy right now.
Okay.
Sure.
But hurry up because my plane will be going soon.
All right, I'll hurry.
Okay. Careful.
Easy, guys.
I'd be happy to give you a lift back to Port Charles.
I go to New York.
Ah, to see the husband, of course. You know, you never did explain to me why you sent Robin to camp so early.
Duke and I have separated.
Oh.
I didn't want Robin to go through it. Once things are settled, it'll be easier for her.
I see.
No, you don't. But it doesn't matter.
Ready?
Why are you so agitated? You find out something about the old man that isn't quite on the up and up?
He's just been away too much. It's putting a strain on our marriage. He's got some decisions to make, and really, until then, nothing's final. I'm going to go see Robin in the nurse's room. Okay, bye-bye.
Okay, Monday the Protection Boys will be here for their second meeting with you, and then later that same day you have your second meeting with the prostitution group.
Well, they're a charming bunch.
Very.
Is that all?
That's it for now.
What about the weekend?
I have great theater tickets.
Well, thank you, but I'll have to pass. I want to go to Port Charles and see Robin and check in with the other club. You'll excuse me, I'm going to go outside and talk to Rodolfo and keep an eye open for Anna.
May I use your phone?
Please do. Thank you for all your help.
You're welcome. Would you mind if I come up for one day this weekend? I'm going to redecorate Duke's club, and I'd like to take another look at it. Well, yeah, that'll be fine.
Good. I'll call you later with the details. Thanks. Bye.
Well, maybe this weekend won't be a total loss after all.
Yeah, man.
hands there, and Robin, of course, has gotten poison ivy. I mean, it was just one thing after.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Prunella, what are you doing here?
G'day, Robert. The nice officer let me in, you know. He just smiled and nodded and said, go right in. He didn't ask for identification or anything. You don't mind, I hope.
Oh, good. My cousin, Prunella Witherspoon from Australia.
Oh, really? I never would have guessed that.
So, where you been for the last few days? I thought you'd given up and gone home.
Oh, not on your life. I love it here. The people, you know, the things to do and see. Oh, it really is very exciting. You know, Robert, I went to Niagara Falls and I just looked at the water tumbling down. I mean, it really was very, very impressive.
Where'd you stay?
Oh, here, then, everywhere. You know, I had great fun at your inns, though.
Motels.
Well, whatever. Anyway, I'm here and I'm back to stay, Robert.
Lucky me.
Lucky you. You're not tugging at my leg again, are you?
Never occurred to me.
It's nice meeting you, Miss Witherspoon.
Oh, please. Let's not stand on formalities. Prunella's the name. And may I please call you Guy?
Certainly, Prunella. Well, I have some work to do. Please excuse me.
Oh, yes, please don't say on my account. Although, I really do enjoy your company.
Good day.
See you later.
Well, now that you're back on your travels, what do you intend to do?
You know, Robert, I don't really know. Can you suggest something?
Scorpio.
Hi. How was your visit with Robin?
Why don't we have dinner tonight?
I'd love to.
I have a bottle of calamine lotion on hand. Robin got poison ivy.
Oh, no. Is it catching?
Where will we just stay at arm's length?
No, we won't.
Oh, incidentally, guess who's back in town?
Who?
The world traveler, Prunella.
Oh, good. We'll bring her along.
Bite your tongue.
You're not very nice.
I'll see you later.
I'll betcha. I'll wager my Aunt Martha's golden brooch with a pearl in it that was Cheryl Stansbury.
How'd you know that?
No, she's very nice, Robert. I mean, really, really nice. Anyway, Robert, I just thought I'd tell you I was back, and I better trot along now, you know?
Wait. I've got a special treat for you.
Oh, goody, gumdrop.
Stanley.
Denali, you dog. This is your lucky day.
Hey, old buddy, what's up?
You never really did get to know my cousin Prunella, did you?
No, I really never did.
I think it's time you did. She'll be right over, and thanks for inviting her.
Thanks a lot, buddy. Oh, it must be jet-propelled. Oh, Colton, Sean, come on in.